And tonight we're up Van Frynych, camping on the Brecon Beacons. And we're
Come on, get on with me.
All right. Pitched up on Van Frynych, I think I got that right this time. Nice steady walk up. Temperature is dropping quite quickly. I think we're looking at about just above zero tonight. I think probably the top of Penavan will be around zero, so we'll probably be one or two because we're not quite as high. We're currently at 620 meters, I think this is. As you've seen already, I'm using my Abisko Lite 1 again. I love this tent, very small, but I love it. It's going to keep me nice and warm tonight. And Warren is using his Hilleberg Soulo Black Label because he did significantly better at school than I did. So just looking inside the tent now. Haven't got my air mattress out. Got the Exped Dura R5. I'll be getting that out. And I've got my down bag as well. None of that's out yet. I'm going to be lofting all that later. For tea, I have real Termat tikka masala. Again, absolutely love those. Also brought some chili noodles just for a snack. And a bag of crisps. And I've got my trusty alcohol down here. So I have an Old Speckled Hen. And I also have some single malt, which is the 10-year-old Highland Park this time. So yeah, set for a nice evening. It's beautiful up here. It's cold, but it's beautiful. Look at that. It's cold. Why are we not having beers yet?
Yeah,
have you got something else for me?
Got hot chocolate.
I have a hot chocolate. Look at this. Look at this. Thank you, sir. Cheers, everyone. Thank you, Jeeves. Oh, that's lovely. So you can see, as I said a minute ago, Warren is using the nuclear bunker tonight. Oh, look at it, look. It's a bit overkill, but I think it's perfect. I mean, we've got a fantastic view just here. Yeah, Warren. So just to quickly talk about rucksack weights while we're here.
Oh, I've got,
yeah. To put Warren on the spot. So I estimate mine was sort of 14, 15 kilograms. Warren, did you weigh yours?
Mine's done. Yeah, I've got a few bits in it.
You've got a few bits in it. 26 and a half kilograms.
But then I did add a couple of food, so...
Yeah, you see, I actually tried to lift it out of the car and I physically couldn't. Anyway, cheers, sir.
Yeah, cheers. Cheers. Get me some hot chocolate.
Yes. This is going to be beer soon, don't worry.
Yeah, beer coming up.
So I'm starting to see why Warren's bag was quite so heavy. So he's brought a street light with him, a stadium light. Look at that, look. Did you nick that from Wembley?
No.
It's a good lamp. And then here, he seems to have visited a farmyard on the way and got all of the crops into a heavy box as well. And here we have an entire kitchen. Have you got a sink?
No, I've got a trencher.
I think this is what you call doing it properly. I feel quite minimalist now. Wow. Well, in the tent, trying to keep warm in my sleeping bag, and it's a lovely sleeping bag. So far, doing its job. That's great. We've had a lovely sunset. That's now gone. So, I think it's probably that time. I probably need to ask Warren. Warren?
Hello, yes?
Is it that time?
Beer o'clock?
Yeah. Okay.
Are you ready?
I'm ready. On three. One, two, three. Aha! Cheers!
Cheers!
Cheers! Mm. So tonight I'm on the old speckled hen. I don't know what Warren's on, but it'll be...
I've got an Abbott.
You got an Abbott, so I've got an old speckled hen.
Old speckled hen.
Yeah. It's the beer for seasoned, intelligent gentlemen. None of this fruity nonsense, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? Because we're out for a while, I have two meals lined up. I have my real termat, the chicken tikka, but before that, Warren has very kindly offered to part with some of his extensive vegetable collection. And so I'm going to take him up on that, and I did bring myself just some noodles, which is nice, although it does say you need to fry them as well. I'm not so bothered with that. So noodles and veg to begin with, and then later on, when I'm ready for actual dinner tonight, I will be having my real termite. So yeah, all going down well. So let me just measure. It's 250 mils of water. This is going to be a kind of a guess. I think that's about 250, a bit more. More than 250. Have to drink some of that. And now get the... So these are chili noodles. I think I need to boil the noodles first, so we'll be doing that now. So I have, as per usual, the gas stove here. Let me just move the camera down a bit. Nope, wrong way. Okay. Let me try and get a firm base. There we go. And that on top, so assuming it will light in here. Wind's starting to get up a little bit. Yep. There we go. There's a flame for you. Now I can get boiling my noodles. So noodles are kind of cooking, and I seem to have this bag of hash. Which I assume is the flavouring, but yeah, I'm either going to get full or high. I don't mind which, to be honest with you. Now a little bit of soy sauce as well. Look at that. Oh yes, that's almost appetising. Well, that's looking good, and I had a little taste. It's absolutely gorgeous. And there's the end result. Yum 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 yum. So it's that kind of time in the afternoon. It's about 6 o'clock, it's dark, getting very cold outside. It's going to go down to about zero, I think, tonight. There's a bit of a wind, not too bad, a bit sheltered here. and I can't get my temperature right. If I go outside, I put my fleece and my down jacket on, and all the other layers get cold very quickly. But in here, I'm having to strip layers off because as I get too warm. So I'll find the happy medium sometime. I'm actually on my exped bed, which is very narrow, but it's definitely providing a lot of insulation. The only slight issue is I've pitched the tent on a slope, so I'm kind of migrating that way the whole time. So it should be an interesting night anyway. But I'm a side sleeper, so hopefully it won't be too bad. Starting to get some gusty wind now coming across, so temperature's kind of stabilised at somewhere between 0 and 2 degrees. But we're definitely starting to see an increase in the wind. I mean, we are up at 620 metres, which is what? I don't know, over 2,000 feet. So, you know, we are going to have more wind up here. But yeah, it's not too bad. So here we go. I'm about to get a visit from the custard fairy. All you do is you raise the bowl like this, and all of a sudden, the hostess with the mostest appears. And look at this. Look at this. Oh, that's splendid. Thank you, sir. This really is the best restaurant I've been to today.
Well, oh. A couple of them.
Oh, why not? Oh, look at that.
Oh, you got a...
Look at that.
A whole one.
Oh, go on.
We saved two for the morning.
Yeah, save two for the morning.
There we
Let's
go.
Let's get that bit of grass off. Thank you so much, sir.
Nice.
Very good of you. Very good. I must say, the service here is fantastic.
We do our best.
Fantastic. Oh, brilliant. Waiter!
Yeah, all
right. Where's my bloody chocolate?
All right, all right. That's rude.
Oh.
Delivery service. Do you want to leave it in there?
No, I'm good.
You're okay.
Thank you very much,
no,
sir.
Nice one.
Thank you. Service with a smile. That's what I like. Cheers.
Yeah, nice.
Hats off to Warren. He's been feeding me a lot this evening. So I've got to look at the actual camera. I know Sharon Didcot, my friend, had a go at me for not looking at the camera. So, yeah, I've been well fed this evening, and I don't actually feel like I need to eat the Indian meal that I brought along. So I'll save that for another day. I want to give a quick shout out also to my friend and colleague, James, at work. Hello, James. I know he watches these videos, and hopefully one day he'll be joining me out on one of these videos as well, on one of these camps. It's about 8:30 now, so I'm going to stay awake for another couple of hours. I'll probably go to bed about 10:30, 11:00. But I don't think there's much more to show you this evening. So I'm going to cut to the morning, and yeah, I'm going to get my head down in a bit, and I'll see you in the morning. Look at the camera. The camera's there, not there. Morning. That was a good sleep. Suppose we better see whether there's a sunrise. Just a quick look at the sleep system, actually. There we go. So you got the Exped 5R mattress on top of a Z folding mattress with the Quasar bag on top. Very cozy. And now we'll have a quick look at Warren's tent as well. Look at his big chunky poles. Look at that. Isn't Mrs. Lindley's a lucky lady? Look at this. And who needs standard Dyneema guy line when you have a shipping rope? Absolutely fantastic. Let's see if he's around. Morning, Warren.
Good morning.
Here he is. Look, just a proof. You made it through the night.
Hello. Yeah, absolutely.
Good sleep, sir.
Oh, excellent.
Excellent, yeah.
Lazy.
Yeah. Oh, you can go back to sleep. I won't disturb you anymore. A really good night, and I'm now sitting out in two coats, but enjoying the view over to Cluny Van Vach over there on Black Mountain. We're going to pack the tents up in a minute. Very important that we leave no trace whatsoever. So I think myself and Warren from Lindley's 360 here, subscribe to his channel, really, really good. From the top of Fan Frynch, have a great time, and I will see you in the next one. Cheers.